Okay, so the Big Bang Theory. Look, I've been watching science theory lectures and shows for about since YouTube started, or since I started using YouTube back in about 2007. And I've got my mind around most of the theories, current theory, science theory. I'll be honest, I can't do the mathematics, but I can follow the theory. Now, when it comes to the Big Bang Theory, there's a few things I don't understand, and maybe there are people out there can enlighten me. Okay. The main things that I don't agree with is that, number one, there's a single point and there was an explosion, and the gases and elements came together to form planets and eventually life. Okay, so you've got a single point. So you start asking around, where exactly is the single point? Now, if there's a single point, I don't think that this planet is going to be exactly where the single point is. But that's what they're saying, because they say, you know, you go to Australia and you look out this way and it's expanding. The universe is expanding. So in Australia, if I look out into the sky, it's expanding. It's moving away at an ever-increasing speed. If I go to China, which is how we here in Australia say that if we go to the other side of the world, if I look out, it's also exactly the same. It's expanding and increasing in speed. So that means to me that the single point where it all began is right here on this earth. That's what I'm hearing from the scientists. You know, that's the odds of that actually happening are it's almost impossible just to happen to be at the place where the single point of the cosmic inflation explosion happened. So they're saying that when they get a map of the universe, that within all of that area there was a single explosion and creation happened. Okay, so I'll just try and get my wording right here, but that, you know, out of the room in the entire universe, the single point explosion happened right here, you know, almost symmetrically, you'd be in the middle of the earth, because they're saying that it's all the same here and there, that it's all the same, that it's rushing away and expanding. A more likely scenario would be that it happens sort of out there in space, let's say, in that direction. Okay, so if the single point happened there and Earth is here, then the single point explosion would be expanding out of this area. So the single point would happen here, it'd be expanding universally out that way, this way, that way, and that way from that point. So what would I see if I looked out into space? If I looked out into space this way, then I would see the universe coming toward me at an ever-increasing rate. Say, if I'm in Australia, I'd see it coming toward me. Now, if I went to China and I looked out, then I would see the universe expanding at an ever-increasing rate out that way, going away from me. So the point's here, and I'd see it, the universe coming toward me. And if I looked out this way, I'd see the universe expanding away from me. But that's not what's happening. When scientists look out generally into space, they see the same thing, which would indicate that the single point explosion happened right here. You know, that's a little bit too much of a fluke, as far as I can see. That you'd just be sitting in the point of where, it, you know, the explosion happened. So that's my first foray into science theory. I'd like to do a lot more of this, especially as I get older. You know, reviews of shows and lectures and talks, and because I find it very interesting. It's my main interest is science and science theory, and the theories that come out of the experiments to me are just amazing and truthful. And you know, if you want to look to somebody, a group of people, for leadership, for hope, if you want to try and find a group of people that you can believe in, then it's the scientists. You know, give it all over to the scientists, that's what I say. Okay, so just to illustrate those couple of points once more, say this is our galaxy, then as you can see, here's the point, the start of the Big Bang, and from the Big Bang, all the matter flies out this way, in this direction. Well, you know, obviously it's not going to just happen here, it's going to spread out universally out this direction, but I think what they're saying here is this is a representation of the Big Bang and the actual movement. But of course, if there was a true Big Bang, it would move out in all directions. Now, let's just say that this is our galaxy. So what we would expect to see if we look this way was matter moving towards us, and as we looked out this way, we'd expect to see matter moving away from us. But what I gather from what the scientists say is that when they look out this way, they still see matter moving away. So in other words, if they were to look out this way, they'd see matter moving away. But of course, that couldn't be the case, because the Big Bang started here, the origin, and everything's moving this way. This is a picture of the cosmic microwave background. So this says, according to the Big Bang model, the universe expanded from an extremely dense and hot state and continues to expand today. So in other words, there's a singularity and there's the Big Bang, and it's expanding. Of course, it'd be expanding in all directions. And so something's not right with the Big Bang. If I was to look out this way, I'd notice a difference as compared to looking this way toward the Big Bang.